We want to write the system of equations as an augmented matrix and then solve the system by writing the matrix in row echelon form. So the first thing we should notice is we have a system of three linear equations with three unknowns, which means we'll have a 3x4 augmented matrix. And since the equations are in standard form, meaning we have the x terms, y terms, and z terms on the left and the constants on the right, it's ready to write as an augmented matrix. So looking at the first equation, the first row of our matrix will be 1, negative 2, 3, 7. Looking at the second equation, the second row will be 3, negative 2, 2, 10. And the third row will be 2, 1, 1, 4. Notice how the first column contains the coefficients of x, the second column contains the coefficients of y, the third column contains the coefficients of z, and the fourth row contains the constants. Now we want to write this in row echelon form. We can use this form here as a guide, but let's go ahead and review the specifics about row echelon form. To be in row echelon form, the first non-zero element in each row, called the leading entry, must be 1. Each leading entry, or 1, is in a column to the right of the leading entry, or 1, in the previous row. And then finally, rows with all zero elements, if any, are below rows having a non-zero element. So we have several examples here which are in row echelon form. But I think it's important to also notice that if we focus on the main diagonal highlighted here in yellow, notice most of the elements in the main diagonal are 1. However, they can also be 0 if the system has either no solution or infinite solutions. But also notice that all of the elements below the main diagonal are 0. This is important to notice because this gives us a strategy for transforming the matrix into row echelon form. The process for transforming the augmented matrix is called Gaussian elimination, which means any two rows can be interchanged, the elements of any row can be multiplied by a non-zero real number, and finally, any row can be changed by adding or subtracting the corresponding elements with another row. So going back to our example, we want to start by focusing on obtaining zeros in these three positions. So looking at our augmented matrix, let's first obtain a zero in this position here. Well, if we look at row 1, if this element here was a negative 2, we could then add row 1 and row 3 together to replace row 3 to obtain a zero in this position. So our first row operation is going to be to multiply row 1 by negative 2 and add it to row 3. So the first two rows will stay the same for right now. And now for row 3, we'll have negative 2 times 1 plus 2, that's 0. For the second column, we'll have negative 2 times negative 2, which is positive 4, plus 1, that's 5. And then we'll have negative 2 times 3, that's negative 6, plus 1, that's negative 5. And negative 2 times 7, that's negative 14, plus 4, is negative 10. Now let's obtain a zero in this position. Again, if we focus on row 1 and row 2, since there's a 1 in this position, if we were to replace row 2 with negative 3 times row 1 plus row 2, we would have a zero in this position. Notice how in the third row, each element is a multiple of 5. So let's go ahead and replace row 3 with 1/5 times row 3. So the first row stays the same. Now for row 2, we'll have negative 3 times 1 plus 3, that's 0. Then we'll have negative 3 times negative 2, that's positive 6, plus negative 2, that's positive 4. Then we have negative 3 times 3, that's negative 9, plus 2, that's negative 7. And then we have negative 3 times 7, that's negative 21, plus 10, that's negative 11. And now for the third row, we're going to multiply each element by 1/5, so we'll have 0, 1, negative 1, and negative 2. Now we still need a 0 in this position here. Notice how we don't want to lose a 0 in this position, so we can't use row 1, we'll have to use row 2. And since row 2 has a 4 in this position, if we were to replace row 3 with negative 4 times row 3 plus row 2. This would give us the 0 in this last position. So the first two rows stay the same. So we'll have negative 4 times 0 plus 0, that's 0. Negative 4 times 1, that's negative 4, plus 4, that's 0. And then we have negative 4 times negative 1, that's positive 4, plus negative 7, that's negative 3. And then finally we have negative 4 times negative 2, that's positive 8, plus negative 11, that's negative 3. Now we're almost there. We have the zeros in the correct position. We need the first entry in each row to be 1. So now we're going to replace row 2 with 1/4 times row 2. And we'll replace row 3 with negative 1/3 times row 3. So again, the first row stays the same. Second row will be 0, 1, negative 7/4, and negative 11/4. Again, we multiplied each element by 1/4. Now for the third row, we're going to multiply each element by negative 1/3. So we'll have 0, 0, 1, 1. Now that our augmented matrix is in row echelon form, we're going to write this back as a system of equations to find the solution. So the first row would give us the equation 1x minus 2y plus 3z equals 7, or x minus 2y plus 3z equals 7. Looking at the second row, this tells us that 0x plus 1y minus 7/4z equals negative 11/4, or just y minus 7/4z equals negative 11/4. The last row tells us that 0x plus 0y plus 1z equals 1, or just z equals 1. Notice how this last row tells us that z equals 1 is part of our solution. Now we can perform back substitution to find y and x. So using equation 2 and substituting 1 for z, we know that y minus 7/4 times 1 must equal a negative 11/4. So if we add 7/4 to both sides, we can see that y is equal to negative 4/4 or negative 1. And now we can use this first equation to find the value of x. X minus 2 times y, which is negative 1, plus 3 times z, which is 1, must equal 7. This is going to be x plus 2 plus 3 equals 7, or x plus 5 equals 7. So now we know x must equal positive 2. So if we want to give our solution as an ordered pair, the x coordinate would be positive 2, the y coordinate would be negative 1, and the z coordinate would be positive 1. To verify this, if we were to graph each of these equations in space, we would have three planes in space, which means these three planes would intersect in this point. Let's go and look at the graph of this. Here's the graph of the three planes in space. Notice how these three planes do intersect in a single point right here. And the coordinates of that point would be 2, negative 1, 1. Okay, hope you found this explanation helpful.